can you please stay free Palestine one time? Why did you kill that lady? You killed that lady and got no jail time? No jail time, Alec? No jail time, Alec. You're putting innocent people in jail, Alec Baldwin. Free Palestine, Alec, just one time, and I'll leave you alone. I'll leave you alone, I swear. Just say free Palestine one time. One time. One time. One time, Alec. You know he's a criminal. You know he's a f-ing criminal. Come on, Alec, just say free Palestine one time. One time, just one time, please. And I'll leave you alone. Free Palestine. F- Israel, f- Zionism. Please say it.
And
one time.
Then there comes there it is. That was so Kane and I were kind of joking about this. That was this Alec Baldwin was in some bakery in Manhattan getting coffee or whatever. I don't know what he's doing. I don't care. He's not in jail. And this broad decides, I mean, it was funny, but also at the same time, let them eat each other. I don't care. I don't care. Kane and I were having a conversation about this. We're like, yeah, two dumbs usually don't make a right, but it is entertaining. And I'm okay with that. Welcome back to the show. Dana Lash with you. We're at the bottom of this first hour. I'm okay with that. I don't know if y'all, there was community notes on this because this chick had said, oh my gosh, white devil Alec Baldwin assaulted me because I said he was a murderer or something like that. And the community note was something to the effect of, well, he's not been convicted yet. And there's no evidence that he's actually a white devil, but this woman is a bee and very annoying. And it's comical. They were getting the community notes were getting spicy yesterday, but it is just let them eat themselves. Can I just get a free Palestine? What? A free what? A fictional place? How about free Atlantis? How about that? Same effect, right? Good grief. Except Atlantis now is a resort in the Bahamas. So if you're gonna, they could have a resort in Gaza, but they're too busy digging tunnels and blowing people up and shooting rockets off of elementary school roofs. So there, you know. Speaking of Gaza, guys, I got to tell you, I'm at a loss of words where it concerns one John Fetterman. Now, we've given him a hoodie pass. And is he going for the Umbro pass for life? I don't know. Everybody knows what Umbros are, right? Does anyone not know what Umbros are? I'm looking specifically at our millennials and our older Gen Zers. Everybody knows what Umbros are, right? He does not know what Umbros are. No. Okay, first up, before we continue on this, because it's referenced a lot. Umbros is the short uniform of choice for all high school athletes in the 90s. Girls and guys, come in all colors. And they were so useful, Kane, were they not? You had all different types of the Umbros, all different types. You wore them for soccer practice. You wore them for track. For everything, softball. Everybody wore Umbros. You wore them in gym class. You wore them on the weekends when you went bike riding to your friend's house, Kane, right?
Yeah.
You had Umbros.
Yeah,
I had Umbros.
Several pairs when I was a kid.
Yeah, like everybody had Umbros. It was the thing that everybody had. Steve, you know what Umbros are? Oh my gosh. Sometimes I love them so much. It's like working with Martians. I love it. They're like, what?
I'm going to buy them rotary phones for Christmas.
Oh man. Or the clear phones where you can see all the guts and it has the long cord. Man, those are the jam. That's when you know you arrived as a teen. Did you have a clear phone where all the guts inside were neon colored?
And it had lights in there too.
Yeah, lit up when it rang. Yeah. So great. Everybody had Umbros. Now, I don't think he wears Umbros because his are quite long. And I think they're mostly of a jersey knit material. We'd call that sweat, you know, like a sweat material, sweatshirt. But no. Now you got to say it's a jersey knit material. You got to make the fabric sound way fancier than it is because, you know, inflation, right? So you got to, it's a $5 upcharge for a damn pair of sweatshorts. No, it's not a sweatshirt. It's a jersey knit. See, that's how you do it. I just sold you into paying $5 extra for sweatshorts. Today, we're diving into the future of health with Lumen, the world's first handheld metabolic coach. So what exactly is Lumen? Lumen measures your metabolism through your breath. You just breathe into Lumen first thing in the morning, and it tells you if you're burning fat or carbs. It's like having your own personal nutritionist in the palm of your hand. And I really like the idea of this thing. So not only does Lumen give you real-time insights into your metabolism, but it also provides personalized nutrition plans tailored to your body's needs for the day. And here's why metabolic health matters. Your metabolism is your body's engine, powering everything from your workouts to your sleep. And Lumen helps you optimize it for easier weight management, improved energy levels, and better overall health. But what about metabolic flexibility? Well, it's crucial. That's your body's ability to switch between using different fuel sources like carbs and fat. And Lumen, it helps track and improve your metabolic flex score, putting you in control of your health journey. So if you're ready to take charge of your health, head over to lumen.me and use code DanaShow at checkout for $100 off your very own Lumen. That's lumen.me and use code DanaShow for $100 off. And remember, it's .me. That is lumen.me. Don't wait. Your health journey starts now. So I think he's going for like the perpetual Umbro pass now. So I can't read how this is written on my audio list, sadly. But audio soundbite 5, if you please.
It's completely reasonable to want a ceasefire or to have a different view on that. Absolutely, that's a democracy. But it is not appropriate or legal, or it's helpful to advance your argument if you show up in a Starbucks with a bullhorn and start yelling at people, and that doesn't make you noble, it just makes you an asshole. It's very American to protest and to do that in the appropriate way, then I absolutely support that. I'm not suggesting that you have to agree with my view, but it's just saying it doesn't really allow you to disrupt lives and to inflict those kinds of damages on people that are just trying to get on with their lives.
Wow. I really wish that I could use that as a band name. The Noble Blank Hole. So great. He's not wrong. He's like, if you're taking a bullhorn into a Starbucks, first off, how do you make an annoying place more annoying? You take a bullhorn into it, right, and you start screaming about freeing a fictional place that isn't actually not free, right? That's how you make a place more annoying. He's not wrong. Where's his wife at? I love the fact that we don't know. Where's she at? It's like when she's not there, he's on fire. What is up with that? I don't know. I don't want to be mean to him. And I'm not going to sit here and say, I have a friend who's like, stop celebrating every damn thing that John Fetterman says. He's a Democrat. He's still stupid on everything else. But hold up. We live in weird times. I will take allies on certain issues where I can get them. I'm okay with that. I am okay with walking us back to a ground of normalcy by giving back pats for things that someone may do that the rest of their party doesn't do. And the rest of their party makes it difficult for someone to do that. I bet he's not invited to sit at the cool kids table in the Senate lunchroom anymore. I mean, I'm sure they do that because they're all petty little Democrats. I'm sure they do that. We got to send him. Yeah, we got to get those, Kane. Kane goes, we need to send him a Dana Show hoodie. He would never wear it, but maybe he would. Right. I don't care. But I just feel he's got the hoodie pass. Now it's like he's going for the Umbro pass. Do you know what's going to happen? Have you ever seen that meme where it's Vince McMahon and it's a 3-panel thing and he makes a happy face and then he's real excited and then his head blows up for the 3rd panel? Like if Fetterman were to come out and be like, yeah, everybody needs to leave the Second Amendment alone, I would be the 3rd panel Vince McMahon. My head would explode. I wouldn't know what to do with myself. I don't know. I don't know. How would I deal with that? I'm not quite sure. He just needs to, I think, to stay on this line, to stay on this path. At least he's saying it, and he's right. Why are people afraid to say that? Why are people afraid to say that? Like, you're just a jackwagon if you're going into these private businesses and you're doing this stuff, if you're blocking roads. Thanks for watching The Dana Show. Make sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell, and stay tuned for more content.